Oh, Freddy. I hardly recognized you in your police togs.
You certainly scrub up well.
I thank you for your help in collecting these bounties. I am impressed with all you have accomplished, and I wish you luck with your future endeavors.
Building a picture gallery, are we, Wynette?
Present for my good friend Adam.
Do you treat all your friends this way?
Never mind that now. I wanted to thank you for all your help. You twins are nothing if not diligent. Please accept this as a token of my gratitude. Well, the wheels of London never stop. Always more work to be done.
Champions of the street, champions in the ring. Is there anything you two can't do? Hmm? Are you quite sure you don't remember me? That night at the laboratory? No? Oh, well, never mind. I have a little something to commend your remarkable performances.
That night in the laboratory, hmm?
Definitely not what you think.
Oh, good. You're both here. I have something to give you.
That really isn't necessary.
More gifts?
You spoil me, Greeny.
Templar numbers are dwindling, and I hate to admit it, but the Rooks are thriving.
Did you hear that, Evie? Thriving.
Your time in London has been well spent. I am proud of you.
Listen to me. I have been ordered to keep your rallies off the streets.
No, you must listen to me. The people in this city are in dire need of your assistance. Oh, you are Jacob Fry, are you not? And Miss Fry?
We're at a disadvantage, sir.
Karl Marx. Much like you, I am an activist of sorts.
You've got the look of a man who wants something.
Indeed. You've done more for London citizens lately than any endeavor has accomplished in a decade. But those citizens were already well provided for. I challenge you both to help those who really need your assistance, the working people.
An interesting challenge. We accept.
Shouldn't we at least talk about these things for...
Sod it. We accept.
I'm organizing a discreet meeting with some like-minded friends to discuss trade unions. Alas, the police seem to have noticed my activities. They've stuck to me like flies on shizer. In any case, I need you to help me get to the meeting without the interference of the police. You see? There's one of their damn spies now.
on, this one's tricky.
Tonight, sundown, the usual place.
I'll be there.
You know, I had similar problems with the police in Paris. Well, Paris and Brussels. And also, perhaps Cologne. Our next worthy ally awaits us in a nearby pub. Onwards. No doubt the police already have agents stationed within. I'll wait here until the coast is clear.
Thank you.
What's going on over there?
There's something going on.
Some sort of commotion.
good mother. All children need to be taught a lesson. Tickets, please.
I believe our work here is complete. Come, let's slip away and get to the meeting. I do appreciate your assistance in this matter. Only when workers are able to assemble freely and in strength will we be able to achieve the reforms we most assuredly deserve. Might I trouble you to stay nearby until the meeting is over? I fear we may yet meet with some mischief.
Don't you worry.
It seems the movement is ever doomed to be betrayed from within. Will you fetch the gentleman back here? I would look him in the eye and ask why he went back on his brethren.
Mistake.
Let's go for a stroll.
Looks like a mess.
Looks like bother to me.
What the hell was that?
What's all that argy-bargy about, then? What could be happening?
What's happening? What's going on there?
Oh!
Simon, my friend, what possessed you to do this thing? Has the party not taken care of you?
Governor, at the mill, see? Any man what joins a union will be put out of work come sunup. How long will the party feed my family for?
If we do not stand together, we are lost. My heart is broken, Simon. Please go. I thank you, my friend. I hope you will continue to aid the struggle when the opportunity. My poor friend, Frank Morris. His son dropped dead of exhaustion after finishing an 18-hour shift. Frank is consumed by grief. He blames the government for refusing to protect the rights of the worker. I can't blame him for his rage, but I fear his actions have gone too far.
Nice work.
He plans to steal a shipment of nitroglycerin and use it to attack the Houses of Parliament. Killing people and destroying property solves nothing. Democracy is the only road to socialism. Please stop him before he gets himself or anyone else killed. I expect he's on his way into the City of London now.
That must be the explosives. No sign of Mr. Morris yet, though. Focus.
You tell Marx I don't need his help. All yours.
Come on! Faster!
What do you expect me to do? Even a dog will fight if he wants to open.
Come on!
I don't like being told what to do.
We're trapped in here unless you ascend and deal with them.
I have her in my sight!
Who are you? You can't see her! I need help in fighting her!
Atta girl.
They got the nitro back. That must please you.
Not a bit. I doubt their designs on the explosives are any nobler than yours.
Yeah.
Damn. Now I'll have to work out where they've taken it and why.
I might be able to assist you. Find me in Southwark when you're ready. They're moving the shipment, but we must go now. There's a carriage on the next corner. If we hide within, they'll drive us right to it.
It's time you went home. I'll hide in the carriage alone.
Home? Back to a cold and cheerless house where I'll wear black gloves and sport a weed on my hat for a year. Then I'll return to the factory like a small cog in the great wheel of capital. No, I want justice. I must have those explosives.
I grieve with you, but would your wife want to see your hands stained with the blood of so many?
I am trying to build a better world, to ensure that no one suffers what my son did. Pray tell me, friend, how much blood do you consider that to be worth?
I'll keep those ones alive until they take me to our destination.
I'm sorry, but my need is greater than you know. Justice will be done. Wait, don't
shoot! Mr. Morris!
Poor man. I hope he finds some kind of peace.
Now to destroy the crates! No one is getting their hands on this hellfire!
What's she doing here? I'll get her. I want her bleeding and broken!
Yeah.
Mr. Morris, I see. I was afraid it would come to this. He was a good man, but even the best of us can lose our way when blinded by grief. Still, I thank you for preventing a greater tragedy. Corruption reigns here, I'm sure of it. The number of people injured by their machinery cannot be calculated, and yet the company continues to prosper. They must be stopped for the sake of the poor workers they abuse. If only we had some form of proof. There must be records of the accident somewhere inside, which would surely prove their malfeasance. I should think you'd need to find the foreman. But how you'd convince him to give you the reports? Perhaps if they think the factory's on fire, you might bluff your way past.
I've got money. should be just inside here. Oh, there they are. Good. They're safe.
Oi! What do you think you're doing?